Let us emphasize the previous video with numbers. This is the profit and loss statement of XYZ company with 800 as cost of goods sold, and here is how this figure was reached. The beginning balance for the direct materials inventory not used in production is 700, and the company purchased additional direct materials during the current year with a cost of 400, to get the direct materials available for use in production. At year end, the direct materials not used in production is 600, which means that the cost of the direct materials issued to production during the year is 500. Direct manufacturing labor costs used in production amounted to 200, and the indirect manufacturing costs amounted to 100. The sum of these three gives us the total manufacturing costs incurred during the year, 800, which is booked here in the work in progress inventory account. There is a beginning balance in the work in progress account, which are the manufacturing costs incurred during the previous year for production that is still uncompleted. By adding these two figures, we get the balance of manufacturing costs incurred for production. At year end, the ending inventory in the work in progress account was 1,400, and therefore, the cost of goods produced during the year is 900, which is also booked here in the inventory of finished goods account. There is a beginning balance for finished goods that were produced during the previous year but not sold yet with a cost of 600. By adding, we get the cost of goods available for sale. At the year end, the ending inventory of the finished goods that were not sold was 700, and therefore, the cost of goods sold during the year is 800, this figure here.